In October 2008, a white paper was published online titled Bitcoin, a Peer-to-Peer Electronic Cash System. This 9-page white paper outlined the design and justification for a digital currency or cryptocurrency controlled by no single entity. Traditionally, we trust a singular bank to conduct financial services on our behalf. With Bitcoin, the intention is to do what no other attempt at a cryptocurrency could do before: create an anonymous, trustless, decentralized currency. Instead of trusting any individual humans, we put trust into math, cryptography, and logic. We trust the Bitcoin protocol, even if we don't trust any individual in the network. This cryptocurrency relies on computational power to cast votes. As mentioned earlier, this is called proof of work. And as we have seen earlier, the idea of solving a cryptographic hash puzzle was also used in Hashcash. Satoshi wrote in the white paper that this is meant to enforce a one CPU, one vote system, such that every computer only has the ability to cast one vote in the consensus process. This is different from the traditional one identity, one vote process used in government elections, because we can't assume that each real-world identity has only one digital identity. In addition, each person maintains their own identity through public and private keys, authenticating themselves through blind signatures, which was introduced by David Chaum from DigiCash. This ensures that every user maintains their own privacy until they voluntarily choose to reveal themselves. In Bitcoin, every full node maintains their own copy of the blockchain, similar to how in BitMoney's protocol, every participant maintains their own individual database to keep track of how much money belongs to each user. Bitcoin was designed to be a deflationary currency, meaning that there will only be a limited amount of Bitcoins that will ever exist, specifically 21 million. Every miner gets a block reward for finding a block, but this block reward decreases over time. It began at 50 Bitcoins and is half every 210,000 blocks. Eventually, the block reward would become zero, at which point 21 million Bitcoins will have been minted. Interestingly enough, Satoshi chose to include a message within the first block of the Bitcoin blockchain. This information is a powerful glimpse into the mentality and motivations of Satoshi Nakamoto. As we will discuss further in the next module, the Coinbase transaction gives the miner a block reward. This particular transaction has empty space into which extra information can be included. Satoshi chose to reference the story in the Times of London mentioning a chancellor bailing out a bank. As we can tell from several posts and comments made by Satoshi, he was not fond of the modern banking system, particularly fractional reserve banking. Bitcoin's design aims to eliminate these issues. During this first year, people send Bitcoins to each other out of interest, playing around with the software. And during this time, however, Bitcoins were never exchanged for any tangible good. And then in May of 2010, this post showed up in the Bitcoin Talk forum. Feel free to pause the video and read through the post or follow the source link. So in the post, we see that in it, a man named Laszlo Hanek asked for pizza in exchange for 10,000 Bitcoins. And on May 22, 2010, he received a $25 worth of pizza in exchange for his Bitcoins. And this was the world's first ever Bitcoin transaction for a tangible asset. In this moment, Bitcoin went from worthless internet money to something that is worth real value. As a fun fact, as of March 15, 2018, the pizza that he ordered are now worth $81 million. And here's Laszlo's reporting back on the forum about the pizza's safe delivery. Most people ridicule Laszlo for spending Bitcoins on such a small purchase. However, they're not aware that Laszlo wanted to see Bitcoin flourish. Before this purchase, the idea that Bitcoin could be used to purchase real-world goods was ridiculous. For most people, mining Bitcoin was merely a hobby. This purchase validated the use of Bitcoin for its original purpose as a currency actually used for buying goods. So in a way, by trailblazing the currency's use, Laszlo is a hero to Bitcoin enthusiasts. This was the very first time a Bitcoin transaction traded quote-unquote magic worthless internet money for a tangible item of value, and therefore Bitcoins have value. However, it's not like Bitcoin were worth that much when Laszlo spent them on pizza. It took years of development and spread before Bitcoin became accepted as legitimate technology, yet it still got a way to go before reaching worldwide legitimacy.